Sometimes we so badly want something that we fail to bridge the gap between love and obsession. We get ready to pay any price to fulfill our obsession and get trapped. Aigam Alev is a Russian millionaire who is obsessed with his ex-wife Eva, who left him for a successful fashion designer Hamid Hussein. Aigam never wanted to take the obvious route, which would be to go and meet her. Instead, he needed her to come to him. So he believed that killing is acceptable if it is done for a good reason, such as getting back the women he loves. He wanted to destroy the world. So with this motive, he travels to the glamorous Cannes International Film Festival, where Eva would appear with Hamid. Every time he kills someone, he sends a text message to Eva that means he has destroyed someone's world, just so that she would know that not only is he ready to welcome her back, he will gladly bury the past and ask no questions. So he begins a 24-hour campaign of extraordinary violence. Aigar is waiting at a bar in Hotel Martinez to capture a sight of his wife and her lover. He is armed and has carefully executed plans to slaughter people to get his wife back. In the morning, he wakes up with the motive of finding someone who can sacrifice in the name of love. He observes a young woman, Olivia, who must be 20 at most, selling some craftwork and jewelry. He pays her enough to attract her attention and starts a conversation with her. Initially, Olivia was amused by him. However, after some time, by knowing his motive of destroying the world, he gets uncomfortable, but he forces her to sit and hear him by showing the gun. He then promises her that he won't shoot her if she do as she was told. The girl obeys him and sits down. After some time, he kills her using techniques from Sambo, which is the art of killing swiftly with one's bare hands, without the victim realizing what is happening. Olivia appears to have gone to sleep in his arms, but before leaving, Aigar murmurs, "As you see, I kept my promise. I didn't shoot." Returning back, he sends a message from his phone to Eva. Gabriella, a struggling actress from Chicago, is worried because she had spent almost all of her savings to come to Cannes and was 25 years old, which is old in film industry. She is convinced that fame is the ultimate reward in a world that believes celebrity to be the supreme achievement. Then she receives a call for an audition and prepares to leave. Olivia's parents approaches her and shakes her unresponsive body. Aigar started feeling that he had chosen the wrong person as his first victim. However, he convinces himself that the young lady will understand that her death was not futile but was a sacrifice in the name of greater love. Leaving her, he goes on to look for his next victim, so he enters the bar and orders a pineapple juice. And he finds an important looking man, Javed Swild, and decides to kill him. He even asks the waiter that would it be acceptable to destroy a universe in the name of a greater love? Then suddenly he realizes that he should not have asked the question. He is convinced that since everyone will die one day, some must do so now in the name of greater love. Javed is a successful and rich film distributor, and he used to keep a list of things that are normal, since normal things are not what one considers them to be. He, however, became so successful, which is the reason he never goes anywhere without his two safety officers. Then he feels a sharp prick on his back and finds a small needle and believes that it must be some prank. He and his security guards are not alarmed until he begins to lose feelings in his arm and instructs them to call an ambulance. Maureen contemplates her life as an ambitious filmmaker. She has secured a 10-minute meeting with Javed, for which she is sure that he would transform her life. She is excited and ready to accept whatever he offers to get a chance. However, she runs after him as she sees him in an ambulance going to hospital. Gabriella cracks the audition, realizing that she has nothing to lose, and she is told to meet Mr. Gibson, the director. Inspector Savoy and pathologist discussed about Olivia's death, and Inspector learns from the pathologist that she was killed by someone expert in martial arts. And then Savoy instructs someone in the police station to interrogate her boyfriend for what he knows about martial arts. Eva and Hamid arrive from a lunch in a helicopter. He attempts to engage her in conversation, but she seems removed. She had just received a message from Igor that, "I have just destroyed another world because of you, Katyusha." Igor was the only person who calls her by that name. Eva got nervous and fears for Hamid. Jasmine's real name is Christina and is 16 years old. Despite her black skin, she is extraordinarily beautiful. She got various offers from the photographers without even inquiring because of her extreme charm. But she denied to work. However, after some months, she called on the numbers on the business cards given to her by the two photographers and made appointments to meet them. Iger wakes up confused about his purpose and is guilty for killing people for no fault of theirs. He decides to surrender to police, and so he confesses killing Olivia to the first policeman he meets, but is dismissed for being in sun for too long. The confusion in Iger's head is slowly disappearing, and he takes it as a sign from God and decides to continue his mission. Gabriella goes to meet the director of the film and the star. She makes an honest impression on both of them. Gibson explains her the conditions of the contract and invites her to the party. Hamid prepares to go to fashion show, but Eva tries to delay. Then he spots a fashion designer who employed him in his youth. He was financed by a sheikh for his education. He later used the sheikh's contacts to open his business, and now, after getting success, is ready to produce a movie. Savoy finds a report that Javits was laundering cash from illegal sources using film distribution as a front and was under scrutiny. So he believes that it was likely that he was slaughtered to avoid any witnesses. Iger meets a drunk Maureen, who after losing all her chances with Javits gets attracted by Iger's elegance. He invites her to a lonely spot where she is murdered by him with a blade. Jasmine meets a photography agency who tried to fish 2,000 euros out of her, but she refused and was left heartbroken. However, the second photographer she finds was much professional, and Jasmine falls in love with her. Gabriella reaches her hotel room called the Temple. There were a lot of products and accessories by many designers that are kept strictly to be given to people who have a lot of fan following for the advertisement. She is dressed and sent to walk on red carpet. Iger is getting doubts and wants to quit, but he tries to convince himself by thinking of the time when Eva asked for a divorce, and he discovered that she was having an affair. He learned that she thought he was unbalanced and that she was scared of him. He considers all this her regret and that she wants to come back to him but doesn't have courage to do it. Hamid and Eva attend a fashion show. He observes Jasmine there and realizes that she could bring much more attention to his brand. Eva receives more and more messages and is terrified but says nothing to Hamid. Three murders in one day. Savoy is asked to get in touch with Stanley Morris, who explained him the lack of motive and different techniques used in all the murders. Only common thing he observed is the lot of knowledge of the human anatomy. They both then decided to wait for the murderer to commit his next murder. Gabriella and the star go up to the red carpet at Cannes and are photographed. Gabriella is anxious and excited. Iger leaves an envelope containing hydrogen cyanide in a random room. Iger starts to imagine the person who will open the envelope. The envelope is covered in a kind of dust. Once in contact with the air, the dust will become a gas and strong smell of almonds will fill the room. Then the person will suffer from an unbearable headache and difficulty in breathing, followed by a desire to vomit. In a matter of minutes, the lungs will stop working, the heart will stop pumping blood, and the death will follow. Iger then stops imagining and gets into a taxi and leaves for the gala supper. Gabriella makes the journey to the corridor where photographers are clicking everyone. She is hopeful but is dejected when everyone begins to click Jasmine coming behind her. Jasmine enters the party feeling betrayed as a partner and agent accept Hamid's offer to work exclusively for him without even asking her. Despite Gabriella hating her for stealing her attention initially, the two women begin to like each other. The police decides to give a press release hinting that the murder of the star and the film director with a poisoned envelope was a crime of passion, so as to not create any panic with the news of the serial killer on loose. Savoy, in his investigation, reaches Iger's room and decides to wait for him to come. Stanley Morris studies the death of the star and other victims and concludes that murderer is staying for a very short time, and they have to wait for his next killing for more clues. Iger converses with Gabriella and Jasmine and begins to wonder if he had poisoned Hamid and Eva by mistake, as both haven't arrived yet. He begins to fall in despair but notices the two coming along. Stanley Morris is getting frustrated for not getting any clues from the murder investigations. He is worried that this might affect his reputation. However, he concludes that the killer is killing people to send messages to someone and he will stop soon given his frequency. This is the turning point in the story. Hold your breath. Iger is led to the dinner by Gabriella, where Hamid approaches Iger and offers to talk in corner. Eva accompanies him. Gabriella leaves, sensing the discomfort. Iger insults Eva a lot. After the argument, Hamid, Iger and Eva go outside, and Hamid prepares himself to fight with Iger. Iger then asks Hamid, "Would you give your life for Eva?" Iger then takes out a small gun out of his pocket. Seeing the gun, Eva got frightened and tries to manipulate Iger by saying, "I love you, Iger. Let's go away together." Iger then shoots both of them after some more arguing and throws the gun into the sea. Gabriella runs to Iger again, who offers to drop her home. And then she goes to sleep thinking of a really lucky day and more amazing days yet to come. Jasmine returns to her partner and declares that she will not work with Hamid anymore. She had been inspired by Iger's words about love and vanity. Her partner accepts and begins to prepare mentally for the battle with Hamid. Iger is leaving Cannes in his private jet without any guilt except for trying to surrender himself earlier. He is convinced that all the deaths were Eva's fault and she alone could have prevented it. His nightmares are at an end and he is the winner. But he is not alone. The soul of Olivia appears to be guiding him as an angel.